Yes, good morning students. Today we will read the chapter first about the chapter in second class. Okay student, let's see what is the meaning of word. First we will see what is the meaning of word. So student, look at the board. A group of letters that has a meaningful sound or sense is called a word. So a student, a group of letters that has a meaningful sound or sense is called a word. Okay, a word is the smallest unit of language that has a meaning. So student, word is the smallest unit of language that has a meaning, जिसका कोई ना कोई अर्थ होता है, जिसका कोई ना कोई मीनिंग होता है. We can write or and speak a word. We can write and speak a word. एक वर्ड को हम स्पीक भी कर सकते हैं और राइट भी कर सकते हैं. आई इज ऑल्सो अ वर्ड. आई इज ऑल्सो अ वर्ड स्टूडेंट्स. आई इज ऑल्सो अ वर्ड. सो आई इज यूज्ड, एज अ वर्ड ऑल्सो. We can make a sentence by using a group of we can make a sentence by using a group of words. जो भी sentence हम बनाते हैं बच्चों, उसको हम एक words के group के द्वारा बना सकते हैं. मतलब कि words का जो group होता है उससे हम sentence बना सकते हैं. जो so that has a meaningful sense, जो उसका सेंटेंस का भी एक मीनिंगफुल सेंस हमें देता है. सो दिस सेंटेंस ऑल्सो मेड बाय द यूजिंग ऑफ ग्रुप ऑफ वर्ड्स. वर्ड्स मे डिस्क्राइब अ पर्सन. वर्ड्स में डिस्क्राइब अ पर्सन, ऑब्जेक्ट, एक्शन, फीलिंग, प्लेस. ओके, वर्ड्स में डिस्क्राइब अ पर्सन, ऑब्जेक्ट ऑब्जेक्ट एक्शन फीलिंग प्लेस और इमोशंस. ओके, सो लिसन स्टूडेंट, वर्ड्स डिस्क्राइब कर सकते एक पर्सन को भी, ऑब्जेक्ट को भी, एक्शन को भी, फीलिंग्स को भी, प्लेस और इमोशंस. ओके, आई होप यू हैव अंडरस्टूड दैट अ ग्रुप ऑफ लेटर्स दैट हैज अ मीनिंगफुल साउंड और सेंस इज कॉल्ड अ वर्ड. सो लिसन स्टूडेंट, अ वर्ड हैज some meaning. Without meaning there is no word. A word is the smallest unit of language that has a meaning. Word ek language ki smallest unit hoti hai jiska koi na koi mean hota hai. We can write and speak a word. I is also a word. I ko bhi hum ek word ki tarah use karte hain. I, because I means main, because we are talking about myself, so I am I. So I is also a word. We can make a sentence by using a group of words. We can make a sentence by using a group of words. कोई भी सेंटेंस जो वर्ड्स के एक ग्रुप को यूज करके ही बनाया जाता है, क्योंकि किसी भी सेंटेंस में एक वर्ड नहीं होता, उसमें मोर देन वन वर्ड होते हैं. ओके, वर्ड्स में डिस्क्राइब अ पर्सन, ऑब्जेक्ट, एक्शन, फीलिंग, प्लेस और इमोशंस. ओके, फॉर एग्जाम्पल राम, चेयर, स्पीक, रेस्पेक्ट. जयपुर. ओके, सो व्हाट इज द राम? राम इज अ पर्सन. वी नो अबाउट दिस वर्ड, दैट इज अ person. So this is a person. What is the chair? Chair is object. So this is a object. Speak, what is speak? Speak is a verb. Respect is a feeling, and Jaipur is a place. So listen student, word always has some meaning. Remember, word has always some meaning. Without meaning there is no word. Second one is, words should be arranged in proper order. And let's see compound words. What is compound words? Words made by joining two different words to make a new meaning is a compound word. Okay, see, words made by joining two different words to make a new meaning are called compound words. So students, words made by joining two different words to make a new meaning are called compound words. Let's check some example. Like football, foot plus ball means foot has its separate meaning foot, okay, and ball has its separate meaning also. So when we join two words all, when we write two words all together, then they make a new meaning. Like when we join these words, foot ball, then it's a new meaning. It gives us a new meaning. Football. Football is a game. Football is a, understood that ball is a, that is called football, and it's a game also. So it's it has new meaning. And foot is a separate meaning also. Foot means pair, and you can say ball has separate meaning. So when we join two type, this type of two words to make new word, it means new words has new meaning. So like this type we can make new words. So that is called compound word. Okay, like sunflower. Sun has its separate meaning and flower has its separate meaning. But when we join two words like this, then they make a new meaning. Sunflower. Okay. Let's take one more example. Bed plus room. Okay. Bed has its separate meaning and room also has separate meaning. But bedroom, when we join two words, then this is a bedroom. Okay, I hope you are getting what I'm saying. So student, like this you can make a new word, like this compound word. When we join two words to make a new meaning, that is called a compound word. So I hope student you are getting my video, what I'm explaining. If you have any kind of problem, you can ask me. So listen student, related this chapter, some exercises are given in your book, so you have to complete that exercise as a HW. Thank you students.